Are you looking for a high-capacity portable power bank that also has outstanding output? Then you're in the right place. Hello, I am Wanderer001, and this is my review of the Anker 737 Power Bank. As you can see right here, got a LCD display, which we'll talk about in a moment. This power bank has a 24,000 milliamp capacity. In comparison, the power bank that I was using before this was this Wrap power bank, which only had 20,100 milliamps of power, but the output on this was much less. I do have an affinity for and problem with power banks. So using the previous RAV power, you're gonna notice one big difference, and that is the size. Even though this only has 4,000 more milliamp than this one, the form factor is vastly different. And that's partially due to the high speed output of this. And Anker's new Series 7 devices have what they're labeling as GaN Prime, which is a host of other features, which I'll talk about momentarily. But that is a size comparison from my previous one. But if we want to know the actual dimensions of this, we are looking at 6.13 inches long with a width of 2.15 and a depth of 1.95. So this is a beefy device, and that includes its weight. It is 22 ounces or 630 grams in weight. So this is not going to be something that you're going to be able to stick in your back pocket and carry around with you easily for charging devices. But this device is primarily made for outputting high wattage. What do I mean by that? Well, it can output up to 140 watts via this USB-C port right here. You have two USB-Cs, one is an in-out, one is an out, and then you have a USB-A style port. Some different charging configurations, because you do not get 140 watts per port. That is split amongst all the ports. So if you have one device, you can maximum output 140 watts. But if you start plugging in other devices, that will actually lower the amount that is going to a plugged in device. But if we come around to the front, this is one of the interesting features, and that is this LCD display, which is triggered by simply tapping the button on the side. So for starters, we have a percentage ring, tapping it again, and here, we can see some information. We see battery temperature, we see battery percentage, we see total input wattage, total output wattage, battery cycles, and then screen usage. Not as useful as the other information, but it lets you know, hey, I turn this on, I turn this off, I turn this on, I turn this off. So that's how many times the screen itself has come on. So if I come back here, now it's 118. Tapping again, we have auto screen on and off, which is very helpful, because you don't want to have the screen on eating your battery. So I have that on, and then we come back there. If we press and hold, meaning we long press and hold, there's a couple little cute things that it can do. So if I continue to do this, there's some blinking. It's a neat feature, but one of the other things that I like about this is there's actually a gyroscope in here. So notice that display is going to change. In order for another screen to show up, we actually start having to plug devices into our battery bank here. So I'm just going to put in a low power USB device. And right here, we can see it has the output from the USB-A. It's letting us know right there and outputting, and it's doing under 1 watt there. But it also shows us an estimated runtime for the device that we have plugged into this, which is really great. And then as we start plugging in other things, you will see these light up as well as letting you know, hey, this is how much they're drawing. Now, if in the case like I have a low power device, what we can actually do is if we double tap our button over here, you're gonna see this little green dot. What that's going to do is that's trickle mode. So that's not going to output as much because this battery is primarily for larger devices that require more output. So it's good for your cell phones in that you can get a lot of charges out of it, but it's really meant for something like a laptop or a bigger device. Sadly, I don't have any devices that can take advantage of the full output of this. So I'm kind of future-proofing myself in some cases. The display itself is bright enough that you will see it outside in most conditions, but generally you're going to be using this indoors. You can cup it like that if you need to see the screen better, but in most inside cases, you'll see perfectly fine outdoors as well. I did do a few tests charging this and using the included cable, which is the other thing that we need to talk about. They include a USB-C to USB-C cable, but if we look right here, that is a maximum of 140 watt cable that is included with the power bank. So hold on to this because you're going to use that to charge this. And then they also do give you kind of like a velvety carrying case for it. Not that important, but they give it to you, which is a nice touch. But this cable, using this cable and the Anker charging station here, I was able to charge the 737 power bank here in under 1 hour. And what you noticed here, which was, hey, this will tell you how long you can charge something for. While we're charging this, it actually tells you how long it will take to charge, as we can see from this. Displaying maximum input from the PC USB-C option on the Anker charging station. So we're getting almost 90 watts in. So I'm gonna change that, unplug, and then plug it into the other one, which is not supposed to have 90 watts. So it'll take a second for it to realize how much the input is. That one is also getting about 90 watts. So this particular device isn't gonna pull more than that, but it's gonna show me right down here, estimated time for charging, and then a charging percent right there, which is really nice if you ask me. So you'll know exactly how long it takes to get this charged up. Not only can you fast charge the device, you also can pass through charge, meaning I can charge the power bank and charge something off of this at the same time, which if you don't realize how good that is, you really should. It is an awesome feature that not all portable power banks have. But because this is fast charging, that means it is going to generate quite a bit of heat while it's doing that. In my testing, I found that towards the end, when it was finishing up its charging, it was at about 107 degrees. It's not going to hurt anything because that was mostly on top. There are no little feeties on the bottom of this to keep it off of a surface, but the temperature was really up here. There wasn't any heat dissipation from the sides. Realistically, if we're talking about the rest of this, aside from the gray accent piece that you have on the front, the rest of it is just matte plastic. You do have a little ribbing on the side to give you something to kind of grab onto. I kind of wish that that had a light around it, but that's just me. But it's just a shiny accent piece, and then your business end up here. It's not a lot to look at, but that screen on the front is something that's really cool, and I wish other manufacturers would do. But this is quite an impressive power bank. And again, Anker, they've been around forever. There are a lot of extra technical things with this, which Anker has kind of bundled into their GAN Prime. It's letting you know that this device is more than just a battery that's outputting. It's got a lot of built-in protections to prevent damage to your devices, damage to the power bank itself. And it's because of all of those extra features that the price tag is very hefty for a portable power bank. For half the price of this, you can get two of these. But that other power bank does not have the output that this one has or the rapid charging that this one has. Granted, it's a beast to take with you, but if you're traveling and you have it in a book bag, it's not that big a deal. Or if you're traveling and need to power your laptop, this one will definitely be able to do it. That other one will not be able to. Because of that, if you're in the market for a versatile portable power bank, I highly recommend checking out the Anker 737 power bank. With that being said, I have been Wanderer001. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave it in the area below. And as always, thanks for watching.
If you found this video helpful, consider giving it a like, as that will help other people find the video as well. If you like what I'm doing here, you can always help fuel the next review by buying me a coffee, link in the description below. Last but not least, if you want to be notified when I upload a new video, you know what to do.